So, day one in hell's begun. Welcome to my new home. I've been here for 2 hours already and have 3 boxes in my room. And one of them has the towels. So, this is my video diary, I guess, of my new house. We just moved from Florida and I have no idea how long I'll be stuck in this place. My dad is outside and packing the car. I would help, but he's afraid I'd find a kitchen knife and slit my throat with it. We'll be out there for hours doing this by himself. The upside is it gives me time alone to talk about how much I hate this place. I hate this place! It's cold at the beginning of May. What kind of town is cold in freaking May? Is this an idea of a joke? Does he find it amusing to have me freezing my ass off in spring? Oh, he freezes out there. I hope.
Cameron, dinner now!
It's 4 o'clock in the afternoon. Why is he doing this to me? How long did I sleep in the car?
Don't bother, Cameron.
I just want to know how long I was asleep for.
Look, you're trying to get me to give something away.
Why would you just tell me where we are? It's not like it matters. You want me to do anything differently?
I said, don't bother, Cameron. You know why I'm doing this. You brought this on yourself. Now finish your dinner! I don't care! Finish it anyway!
He's being paranoid. I didn't even do anything. He just wants an excuse to control me. I was out one night, late. There were some train tracks in my house. All the kids left work beside them. I didn't mean to jump in front of the train, I just slipped, and I froze for a second. I did move. No one had to pull me away. No one had to stop the train. But he thinks I tried to kill myself. I am not suicidal. I froze. I actually froze. He didn't even try to believe me. He just said this has happened too many times. He freaked out and yelled at me, and the next day he said we're moving. I don't even know where we are. I fell asleep in the car. I don't know how many state lines we crossed. He thinks keeping me in this house will somehow make me less suicidal? He's insane! Anyone would be suicidal in this place. It's too quiet. First day of his new job, which gives me the house for 7 hours. Apparently he trusts me enough to leave me alone. He did lock me in, though. Why don't we go exploring? This house may be boring, but it is big. My room, of course. Look, I have sheets now. That has pretty much been the highlight of my week. We have a bathroom. Exciting! A spare room we've already seen. My dad's room, which he's locked. I think he locked all the sharp objects in his bedroom. Okay, fourth floor is everything interesting. See? He's so paranoid. If I wanted to kill myself, I'd find a much more creative way than using a knife. If he's so worried about me killing myself, why doesn't he just throw me in some hospital and put me under suicide watch? I know why. He doesn't really care. He just doesn't want to be held responsible. He wants to say he did what he thought was best, and then he can go to bed happy. If he cared, he might do something that would actually work. He's so pathetic. If I were suicidal, I'd kill myself just to spite him. I am so bored. I'm running out of things to do, so I'm touring the house on my video diary. There's nothing else interesting in the house, so I found a back window and snuck out. And now I'm just walking. This property is freaking huge. There's just trees everywhere. And they're not even interesting trees, so there's not really much to look at.
We do seem to have neighbors. Yesterday I thought I saw someone hanging around the fence.
Hey, did you just move in?
Yeah, I'm Cameron. I'm checking out the apartment today.
Haley, nice to meet you. Are you filming this?
I'm keeping a bit of a video diary.
That's so cool. Don't worry, I won't sue you for copyright violations or anything. So, where'd you move from?
St. Petersburg.
Florida. Wow. Why'd you move here?
It wasn't my decision. My dad told me 3 days before we left.
Really? Why would he do that?
He was worried I would...
Cameron! Dad, I was just talking. I was just getting out of the... Hey!
Get the hell back in the house!
Hurting me! Stop it!
Hey, Cameron!
You're gonna get back in the house!
Well, that was fun. Sneaking out midnight to get my camera, which I had to leave lying there because my dad is freaking insane. I was just talking to her. It's not like he caught me running away. Of course I was going to ask where we were, but he didn't know that. He doesn't have to be such a jackass all the time. I'm 15. I'm not some little kid that needs to be locked up to be kept in line. Not only that, he bruised my arm. If I still have my phone, I call CPS. See this? Take a good look. Evidence of physical abuse.
So it's 5 a.m. and I couldn't sleep. I was writing and I looked out my window and it was completely dark and this light just appeared. It appeared in the middle of the forest and it freaked me the fuck out because it was just there. It just showed up. I don't know why I'm so shooken up about it, but it started moving and it was like it wanted me to follow it. I don't even know. It was like it was staring at me. God, how long has it been since I slept? Just look. There! There, you see? What the hell? What the hell? Is someone trying to freak me out? Well, it's working. And you see how low it is? It's not a freaking star or anything. I don't like this. I'm done with this. I'm going to bed. I'll down a bottle of sleeping pills if that helps. Dad?
What is it? I have to go.
Did you see that light last night?
What light?
I woke up around 4 or 5 a.m. and there was a strange light. And the other night.
Look, I don't have time for this, Cameron. I have work.
But did you see it?
No, I didn't. And I was awake. You're just seeing things because you never get enough sleep.
Dad?
What?
Can I check out the town today?
Look, you know you're not allowed to leave. I can't have you jumping in front of a train again or doing anything else reckless.
Wow, Dad, you don't believe a word I say. I'm not going to kill myself. You can't keep me in here forever.
I am your father, and I say you're staying in this house until you're not a danger to yourself. I'm not having my daughter kill herself, too.
Don't you dare bring Mom into this.
Finish your breakfast and stay in the frickin' house.
Unbelievable.
Show more footage over the past few days, but I just deleted it all because it's too boring. I mean, I should kill myself just to spite him. He deserves it. He has no right to bring my mom up. She didn't kill herself. She didn't. When I was 6, she finally decided she was fed up with my dad yelling all the time. She told me she would be gone for a few days and then she'd come back to get me. But she never came back for me. My dad just said she left us. Both of us. I didn't know any better, so I believed him. I was 10 when I found out she died. I talked to my aunt for the first time in 4 years when she called for my dad and I answered. She said that my mom was dead and that she'd been killed coming back to our house. Police say she hit the other car, so that's why my dad said she killed herself. But she didn't. It was an accident. Big accident, and I didn't even know about it for 4 years. She wouldn't have left me with him on purpose. She was just doing it to find a place for us to live. Now he tries to kill me by saying he doesn't want me killing myself too. Two. How can he do this to his own daughter? It's like he doesn't even care a little bit about me. It's so fucking messed up.
Winter break 2013, we finally managed to drag Cam out of her house. Her depression was getting really old.
We feel bad, we really do, but it's been months since she's come out with us.
Hey, Cam!
I told you guys not to touch my camera.
We were only messing around, trying to have fun like we used to.
I thought sitting on the beach was fun.
We've missed you, Azul. Seems like you're mad at us.
I'm not mad, I just haven't been up to hanging out lately.
You used to love coming to the beach with us.
Yeah, I used to. Why don't we go back to your place and watch a movie instead?
There you go. Just like old times.
Haley!
Cameron, are you okay?
Why wouldn't I be okay?
Your dad seemed pretty angry the other day. I didn't know if he...
It's fine. He just doesn't like me going out on my own.
He doesn't like you going out in your own yard?
It's a long story. I don't want to get into it right now.
Okay. I see you're still filming.
Yeah, it gives me something to do. We're still unpacking and I can't find any more movies.
You can come over to my house and watch something. You like old horror movies?
Yeah, maybe. I'd have to check with my dad.
No, I can call someone for you if you need help.
It's fine. He doesn't usually grab me like that. He's just mad that I snuck out.
Like you're doing right now?
Exactly like I'm doing right now. Don't worry, he's at work. He won't catch me again. Can I ask you something?
Sure.
This is going to sound weird, but have you seen a weird light in the trees at night?
What kind of light? Like a headlight? A flashlight?
Like a really bright ball of light shining out in all directions?
I don't think I have. And I've lived here for 3 years. Sorry.
It's fine. I was just wondering. So, what do you do for fun around here besides reading?
Well, sometimes I like to climb trees and do some bit of art.
Haley's nice. She likes old books and movies. She has a black and white TV in her room. If I ever am allowed out of this place, maybe I'll go over and watch something with her. Oh, also, I found out where we are. Welcome to Granville, Ohio. Apparently it's about 35 miles out of Columbus. How my dad even found this place, I don't know. It does explain why it's 47 degrees out. I still don't like it.
So it's 1 in the morning? I don't know, it's late. I saw it again. That damn light. The one that apparently only I can see. I need to know what it was. It was like it was taunting me. Or calling to me. Shit! I know it was around here. I saw it before I turned on the camera. It was just there! There, I knew it! What the hell? Fuck. Okay, screw this. What the hell am I even...
He has no idea I snuck out again last night. I'm surprised he hasn't set up cameras yet. So I just woke up when I heard the car start. Took like 3 hours of fall asleep after being outside. Freaked me out. I want to know what it was, but it just freaked me out too much. I wonder if it would kill me if I jumped from my bedroom window. I'm not going to, but if I were.
It wasn't the first time I saw the light since 3 days ago. I saw it 2 more times, but I didn't bother filming it. It was just the same as the first. Last night, I was curious. Too tired to think about ghost lights.
It's back, in the middle of the freaking day. What is it, 3? Fuck this! Fuck this! It's light out, I'm going out now!
See you at the bottom.
Did you break my camera?
Damn. I don't know if this is still recording, but I hope it is. Damn it, you stupid light, where are you? Is this what you want? Do you want me to die? Fuck, this wasn't supposed to happen. It wasn't supposed to.
Does it still work? Nah, it's broken. I'll take this back to Officer Riley. See what he makes of it. Excuse me, Detective, sir. I found what appears to be this girl's camera.
Yeah, she's always carrying that thing with her.
Appears to be broken.
I'll take it anyway.
As I was saying, it appears your daughter committed suicide by jumping from her bedroom window. Were there any warning signs that she was suicidal?
Yeah. She tried to kill herself when we lived in Florida. That's why we moved here. I thought a new start could be good for her.
I'm sorry for your loss.
I think I fixed it.
Everything appears to be in order.
There's the keys. Your house now.
Thank you. If I may ask, the realtor didn't tell me why you're moving, but she did tell me that she'd only had the house a month.
My daughter jumped from her bedroom window and took her own life. I just couldn't stay here with that memory.
I'm so sorry for your loss. I'll have to make sure my son has a room on the ground floor.
How's that?
He tried to take his life only 2 months ago. What are you looking at? There's nothing out there.
I just thought I saw a light over there.
I just woke up. I had a dream the train hit me. I did try to kill myself. I mean, I did jump from the train, but I wasn't ready to die. I'm not ready to die. I talk a lot about how I'd kill myself just to piss off my dad. I wouldn't. Not really. I've just been lying to myself. I want to know what it would feel like to almost kill myself without actually going through with it. Now that I do, I'm done, I think. Done talking about suicide, done pretending that I'll do it, done lying to myself about it. I'm ready to start new. Life here may suck, but it's only a matter of time before he realizes I'm okay and I'll stop being so controlling. I might learn to like it. I'll make friends with Haley, I'll start school again. I'll move on. When I wake up, that is.
Don't give a f- Let the winter come on. I think I'll try my